Hi everyone, welcome back to another episode with me, Living Free Ashley. Today we are making granola bars. Now, I know that sounds like a pretty simple thing to do, but I feel like finding the perfect granola bar for you is the hardest thing to do. There's just so many types out there. There's protein bars, and there's healthier bars, and then there's really gooey ones. There's no bake, there's bake, there's a whole bunch. And I will link a few recipes up here to some of the other granola bars I've done. But this one I feel is like the closest to what you would find in a grocery store. However, these have less sweetener, less fillers, no packaging, and they're really good for on the go. So the original recipe comes from Minimalist Baker, and her recipe is a no-bake recipe. And she said in her blog that it's best if you keep it frozen or in the fridge. And the recipe looked really good, but I wanted it to be more on the go stable. Like, I wanted it to be able to send it with my husband to work who doesn't have access to a fridge, or, you know, put it in my purse for a day of running around. And I didn't want it to fall apart or get ooey gooey. So I wanted to turn it into a baked recipe, which I did. So let's make some granola bars. All right, so start by preheating your oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit and grease a large baking pan. In a medium bowl, add 3 cups of gluten-free oats, 1/2 cup of dried cranberries, 1 1/2 cups of mixed nuts that are roughly chopped. Mine were salted. I like to keep nice big chunks in there. It's just better for when you're biting into it, I feel. 1/2 cup of vegan chocolate chips, and optional, a pinch of salt if your nuts were unsalted. And then just give that a good mix together and set aside. Have a different large bowl ready, and you're gonna take 2 heaping cups of packed pitted dates, and you're gonna blend them in the food processor until nice, thick, and creamy. Add your blended dates to your bowl. Yes, it does get a little sticky, but that's what helps hold the granola bars together. And then add 1/3 cup of pure maple syrup, 3/4 cup of all natural peanut butter. I had chunky peanut butter on hand, but you can use smooth as well. And then you just need to mix that really, really well until it's all blended. It helps if your peanut butter is room temperature or warmed when you're doing this. Next, add in the oat mixture a little bit at a time and stir it all together as best as you can. This does take some elbow grease and it does take some time. I found that wetting my hands and mixing it and almost kneading the mixture that way really helped. And then once that's all mixed up, you just want to add that to your greased baking pan. And again, with wet hands, you want to spread it out and really press it down. Press down into all of the nooks and crannies and really get it nice and firm. That way your granola bars will hold together really well. And then just bake it for about 20 minutes until the edges are nice and golden brown. Once it's cooled, you can cut them into whichever kind of squares or bars you like. I just wanted to do a few different sizes of bars, kind of bigger ones for my husband, smaller ones for me. And you can see how nice and firm they came out, but they're also nice and soft and delicious and perfect. So like I said before, you can take it with you. The previous batch that I made, I took it with me to work. My husband took it with him to work, and it stayed together, and it was the perfect little snack to have kind of midday when you want a hit of something sweet but not too sweet, and you need that fuel to keep going. And like I said earlier, you save packaging, you save on the sweetness and the fillers, you save the environment, you save the animals, and you save yourself from hunger. I get hangry when I don't eat enough in the day, so these will come in handy for sure. Thank you again for watching another episode with me, Living Free Ashley. Don't forget to subscribe and please like this video if you liked it, and cheers to living free.